What's going on, guys? It's Mr. Affleck 9916. It is time to end the postseason, and as you can see, the Red Sox have defeated the Cubs in the 2018 World Series. I think that's like second or third time they've won it in this road of the show. I want to welcome all of you into this video. Hope you guys are having a good weekend. Started the Olympics today. I watched some cycling and some swimming this morning. It was pretty good. Really exciting end to the cycling race. Two of the 3 leaders crashed, and the guy in third went to the lead, but then two more guys caught him and passed him, so it was a pretty crazy race. Hope you guys are enjoying the Olympics if that's your type of thing. As I talked about that a little bit in the last episode, unfortunately no baseball in the Olympics. That'll be back in the next Olympics. But right now for Jack Davis, it is time to go to the offseason and see what's going to happen with signing a new contract. First off, let's look at some retired players. James Shields retires for the Padres. He was an ace pitcher back in the day. Hanley Ramirez retires for the Red Sox. Edwin Encarnacion for the Blue Jays. So he ended up with 387 career home runs. Not bad. Troy Tulowitzki retires as well. So the Blue Jays losing half their sluggers. Here's a big one for me. Joe Mauer retired for the Minnesota Twins. I grew up, you know, he's one of my favorite players. He finishes with a 309 career average and 2,179 hits. Absolutely fantastic for Joe Mauer. Albert Pujols finishes his career with 588 home runs. He just ended up shy of 600. He didn't hit any in 2017 or 2018, though. I mean, he must have been down in the minors or just on the bench. Adrian Gonzalez retires. Adam Wainwright also retires. So a lot of big names. Pujols and Adrian Beltre, who retired as a free agent, make the Hall of Fame. Beltre finishes his career with 431 home runs. No doubt in my mind that Pujols makes it. Before we sign a contract, let's look at my stats to date. We have 84.2 innings pitched in our career, 67 saves, and 96 strikeouts, an ERA of 2.87. Not bad overall when you're a 79 overall pitcher and just your finished with your second year. I'm okay with that. Let's see what the Padres offer us, though. They offer us about a few weeks after the World Series, 1 year for $507,500. And to be honest, guys, I thought I'd be earning more money than that. I almost made the All-Star game. I wanted $1.2 million for 3 years. That's what I want, because that'll take me to the end of my status of not being able to be a free agent. I want to stick it on the Padres for a couple more years. If they continue to get better, I'm going to stay. If they don't, when I'm at the experience level, I think you need 6 years of MLB service to become a free agent. I'll be heading out of San Diego eventually, but we'll see what happens. As you can see, I do some negotiations. They did not want to pay me much. I just kept going down and down, and I was kind of disappointed that they weren't really offering me that much, because as I said, I almost did make the All-Star game. I'm 25 years old now, and you know, at this point, I'm wanting to make some more money. I mean, I'm a pretty good pitcher in my opinion if you look at my stats from last year, so I don't really understand why the lack of money is there, but hey, whatever. It looks like we're going to end up signing 1 year, $575,000. So we got it up, I think, a little bit from what the Padres wanted. I think an extra $50,000, but not that much when you're making $500,000. So we're heading now to spring training. Getting a look at our rotation. Mike, I don't even know how to say that last name, but Taguchi's pretty good. He's from Japan. He's 78 overall, B potential. He's like 21 years old. And there's the rest of our pitchers. So Taguchi, I think, is going to be a part of this team for a while. He put up really, really good numbers last year. And guys, why? I don't know if you saw it, but Kenley Jansen, why did the Padres go get him when they have me as their closer? For some reason, they have me as the closer over him. It makes no sense. He's way better than I am. I don't get it. Let's look at our lineup. Sam Valencia laying the way off. He's up to an 80 overall. I think I played with him down in the minors. But guys, holy crap. Paul Goldschmidt went to the San Diego Padres over the offseason. I cannot believe it. 31 years old, he hits over 30 home runs a year, 95 overall. A huge addition in the offseason for the Padres. I really hope this is going to make our team better. I looked at the team rankings. We are now 29th instead of the 30th. So we're still pretty bad, but obviously getting Kenley Jansen and mostly Paul Goldschmidt definitely boosted our rankings. And we're still a terrible team, but there is some slight improvement from last year. So hopefully we'll lose about 90 games instead of 100 is what I'm hoping. That's kind of asking for a lot, but you know, we have a young squad of guys and they might get better. I don't know, we'll see. Coming into our first spring training game. Guys, I don't show too many highlights from spring training. I try to get through these games quick. In fact, in the next episode, which will be up tomorrow, I'm going to try to get through all of the rest of spring training. And then, you know, Monday we'll start the regular season in 2019. But playing against the Mariners, as you can see, they bunted the runner over to second. Then a ground ball through the right side. Runner's going to hold at third because the right fielder was in pretty close. So runners at the corners now. 3-2 count to the next batter, and I'm going to walk another guy. Robinson Cano, that actually is. So not very good control for Jack Davis here in this first game. Next batter comes 2-2 count with one out, and Davis is going to miss. That goes to a full count yet again. 3-2 count. I cannot have a walk here. That'll blow the save. It's going to be a ground ball. Left side. Here's a chance for the double play. We get one to second. The throw's over his head. Runner's going to come around third. He's going to score. And this is going to be a walk-off victory for the Seattle Mariners on an air. A horrible way to end this game. As you see, the Mariners are going to have a, what's probably an awkward celebration at home plate because the game just ended on an air from our second baseman who doesn't know how to throw a baseball, apparently. And that is a horrible way to start off our spring training, guys. Let's take another look at that one. It was a routine double play, ground ball to third, and the second baseman just couldn't get it on the flip. So really, really, really depressing that that ends up happening. I am going to do one thing good. I'm going to change my number. Some of you had commented how a lot of games, like my number would change from game to game. I don't know why, but I changed it to number 35. And that is going to be our final number. But now it's showing up as 38. So I don't know what's going on with this stupid number for Jack Davis. It's really confusing. But whatever. Maybe it's a glitch and it won't be the show or something like that. I don't really care too much. It's just a number. I just want to get a World Series ring. That's what my goal is. But playing against Kansas City Royals in our second spring training game, they're going to get started off with a ball in the gap. The runner will come around first. He'll head into second with a double. So the Royals get a runner on. Flash forward to the next batter. We have one out and a runner on second now. It's going to be a ground ball, and the shortstop will make the throw to first in the dirt, and he's going to be safe. So another error by the Padres. Absolutely embarrassing for that to even happen. Next batter, one out. Runner's on the corners. He's going to line this one into right field. This one is going to be caught. Runner comes around. He's going to try to tag up. Here's the throw. He is out at the plate, and the Padres win. Two bizarre endings to two bizarre games to start out the spring training. First save of the year for Jack Davis on the sack fly that turns into a double play. And that, guys, is going to be it for this episode. As I said, tomorrow in the next episode, we will have the rest of spring training. For now, make sure you rate, comment, and subscribe. We will see you next time. I'm Mr. Affleck, 9916. Peace.